Hello, my name is Nina and this is my channel, A Norwegian in Norway. On this channel, you will tag along with me on everything Norwegian. I will bake, cook, be out in nature, be at my cabin, show you nature, customs, culture, genealogy. So if you are interested in Norway and want to learn more, this is the channel for you. Today I'm making waffles. It's one of the most common foods to eat in Norway. I'm starting to make the batter with eggs. I got some stuck on my finger there and some eggshell in the batter. And the first thing I did, which is not shown, is that I melted the butter that is standing behind there so it can cool down a bit before I add it to the batter. Then I had sugar in and we will whisk it until eggnog, like so. And then I add the dry ingredients in a separate bowl. It's baking soda, sorry, and it's cardamom. I have just a half teaspoon measuring, so I have to take double of spoons of everything. I will put a recipe in the description box. And vanilla sugar, and those boxes are so cute, they are like the good old days. They have reinvented the good old days boxes, and baking powder. And then I put white wheat flour, sieved white wheat flour inside. And I always weigh the ingredients because I think that makes it more accurate. In Norway we don't have self-rising flour, so we always put baking powder or baking soda in our flour. And then I whisk a little bit more in the eggnog before I add the milk. This is full fat milk, and then I will add the soured milk. And here I'm not sure if the measurements and the weigh is the same, so I just measure and weigh at the same time to make sure, but it weighs the same. So 100 grams of milk weighs 100 grams, of course, but it's 1 deciliter, 100 milliliters. More whisking. Everything together, and then we will add the dry ingredients. And this is a luxury recipe, so if you want to make a bucket of batter for the church or for the flea market or something, maybe you want to use another cheaper recipe, which it actually exists in Norway, a bucket of waffle recipe. As you might notice, you just saw that I had the butter in there before I whisked it again. And let the batter rest for 10 minutes and then we're heating the iron. Here, this iron needs to switch from red to green. And as you can see, my iron goes to like dial of 7 or something, and where you want the numbers to be is different from waffle recipe to waffle recipe. It's a lot of different waffle recipes in Norway, and this is a thick batter that will rise a lot, and then it needs longer time than a thinner batter that will not rise as much. When the light turns from green to red to back to green, then the waffle is ready. And this batter has a lot of butter in it, so I don't need to butter up the iron every time. I just do it a few times, or maybe just once when I start. So this is the part where we actually put things on the waffles, and you can put we use a lot of sweet spreads on it. You can have nothing. This is the first one. And the second one is only butter. And on the third and sugar, butter and sugar. And on the third one, we have also butter. You can never get enough butter. And we use strawberry jam. Here is the strawberry jam. And on the next waffles, we have even more butter, and then we use something we use in Norway called brown cheese. It's a cheese made of heavy cream and goat or cow whey, and it's reduced down and caramelized, so it's a kind of caramelly taste on it. And if you want to try it, the cow version or the fløtemysost, the easy, the light version is the safest route to go because it's kind of a strong taste. On the second waffle, we have both butter, strawberry jam and brown cheese. And on the last one, we only have sugar. So this is the waffle. This is a big waffle iron that makes 6 hearts. And then you will get about 10 waffles for this recipe. As you might notice, this waffle recipe didn't have any yeast in it, like you do, for example, in Belgian waffles. So tell me what you think of the waffle recipe, and if you try it, leave it in a comment below, or if you want to know anything more about waffles, or maybe get the bucket of waffle recipe, please ask and I'll make another video with that one. And I'm also curious to know if it's able to buy a waffle iron where you are. So please also make a comment about that in the comments below. Thank you for watching. Hope to see you soon. Bye.